I think the debate on net neutrality is very timely. It needs to happen, but it needs to happen at a more balanced level, because I think it's become very divisive. It's become us versus them, and I don't think that's the best way for this debate to proceed. Net neutrality in the United States was implemented after 10 years of discourse, as we heard today, and I think at least a few years of discussion on net neutrality before we impose any rules on it. Obviously, the fact that certain telcos are losing money as a result of the new applications has jettisoned a lot of the balanced argument from the discussion. We need to get those arguments back into the picture, because ultimately, if service providers are not there, we won't be discussing any of this issue. So service provider, we need, but they cannot be central to the argument. At the center of regulation has to be the consumer. What's in it for the consumer? What's the best for the consumer? And the consumer choice has to be maintained, and therefore there has to be no throttling of traffic. There cannot be any prioritization of traffic and no blocking of traffic. Those are broad touchstones, broad principles that these debates need to adhere to. But implementation of those principles in every jurisdiction is going to be different, and it needs to be embedded in the local context in India. The realities of India are that telcos are bleeding in the sense that not all of them are bleeding. On average, they are bleeding. They've paid huge amounts to acquire spectrum, and mobile is going to be the way that they're going to provide access to broadband. That's one issue, and that needs to be kept at, you know, if not at the center, but needs to be kept at the background. The other issue is that you have to also promote innovation. Innovation in a public space, innovation in a public internet can only happen when it is open, when access is allowed. You cannot block certain amounts of traffic and hope that innovation is likely to flourish. So innovation has to be kept in the background. Service providers, health has to be kept in the background, but the consumer has to be at the center of this entire debate on net neutrality. The way the debate, as I said, is happening right now, it's become very polarized and extremely divisive. We need to sit down across, you know, tables and think about this and debate this maturely. A few things that must be kept in mind is that the simple economics of price discrimination one cannot say that price discrimination is something that goes counter to the principles of net neutrality. A number of articles recently that have appeared in the Financial Express point to the fact that the debate on net neutrality has to be much more nuanced. It cannot be led by the heart, it has to be led by the mind. Price discrimination is a feature, an instrument that has been used by service providers not only in telecom but in every industry. But price discrimination means that you can have different prices, but you cannot discriminate unfairly, unjustly. What is unjust, what is unfair, will have to be decided either by the regulator or by the courts. But the law says within the same category of subscribers, you cannot discriminate. Now, defining a category of subscribers, whether you do it by functionality, whether you do it by application, whether you do it by voice, by data, that is something, as I said, the regulator will decide or the courts will decide. There are no other way that it can happen. If the regulator decides, then we'll have to, you know, ensure that it gets enforced. The point is that price discrimination is a recognized instrument in the service provider's arsenal to be able to kind of maximize profits or cross-subsidize as he feels fit. So we cannot allow price discrimination to, you know, be subject to, you know, rules that will not allow it to happen. That's one principle. The second principle is that you cannot block sites for consumers who've paid for access. Deals between service providers, the two-sided markets, as it were, between content providers and between access providers, those kinds of deals would invite immediate scrutiny. Those are things that immediately, you know, the gut reaction will be, you cannot have between two players that have market power, you can't have allow them to have deals that will, you know, increase the speed of certain content to the consumer without his being given enough choice. So that's something that will be frowned upon by law. I'm sure as and when the rules on net neutrality are discussed and they're written about, as it becomes enforceable and implemented, what we will probably see is deals between service providers, content providers and telcos, that will invite a lot more scrutiny than deals between the service provider and the subscriber. So you can have price discrimination at both those levels. You can have price discrimination at the level of the network and content provider, and at the level of the network and the subscriber. And I think the latter, which is price discrimination between the service provider and the subscriber, should there should be a lot more leniency, as long as it's not unjust and discriminatory. There should be a lot of leniency on that, and it should be permitted. But giving consumer access to a minimum quality of service and a minimum speed of the internet, however we define it, as long as the consumer has that, then those who are willing to pay more for greater speeds or more bandwidth, I think that is something that should be permitted and should not fall foul of the principles of net neutrality, however they emerge in India. But deals between network providers and content providers, I'm afraid those should and ought to invite much more scrutiny, because they are the ones who have market power, and they are the ones who can influence the nature, quality, and the kind of content that is viewed by the subscriber, not necessarily at his discretion or at his choice. So those are deals that we have to be wary about, and one doesn't know how this will evolve. But I think net neutrality is still a long way away in India, however we define it. As I said, we'll define it in our local context. It's still a long ways away in India, but I'm glad we've begun to discuss it. And the last point I would make is that we should keep out the debate of OTT and innovative content and innovative, you know, applications separate from the debate on net neutrality, whether how service providers adjust to this new threat of competition from an unlikely source or something that they didn't anticipate a few years ago. This is a separate debate. In the process of creative destruction, in the process of market competition, they'll have to adjust to that. And the OTT debate should be kept separate from the debate on net neutrality.